So this so-called peace deal that Biden has made, that is trying to enforce on the Israeli prime minister, is not good at all. This peace deal will exist of three phases. And if I don't remember incorrectly, the third phase of that so-called peace deal is to release Palestinian prisoners. Can you believe that? Hamas and other civilian Palestinians have slaughtered, on 7th October last year, they have slaughtered innocent Jews in those kibbutz. And then Israel have to go and release Palestinian prisoners. These are people in prison for a reason. So Netanyahu, this is not a good deal for you at all, and you don't need anyone to tell you that. Even the two right-wing parties that you are collaborating with, that are your allies, says that they will topple the government if you make that deal. So proceed to stand strong. God is with Israel. God is with Israel. But Biden is trying to get some extra votes for his the upcoming election. So we are praying that Israel managed to take down each and every Hamas terrorist, and we are praying for a total change in Gaza. You can't proceed like that. These people want to be close to you so they can manage to kill as many Jews as possible. Some people in your government, Netanyahu, and I also believe yourself as an intellectual man, you understand that the closer these people come to you, the more Jewish blood will be shed. And unfortunately, other people in this world also wants to see Jewish blood being shed. They are not satisfied. That maybe goes for Biden also, since he's coming up with this peace deal just to make himself popular. And I totally agree with President Donald Trump when he says that he don't understand how American Jews can vote for Biden, can vote for the Democrat Party in the United States. You have seriously to wake up and smell the coffee this time. These Democrats, so-called Democrats in that Democrat Party, they are not for you, Jews. They are not for you. Just as they are not for Afro-Americans or any other person in the United States. They are for themselves and their own positions. They do not care about ordinary civilian people, you see. So we, as I said, in this ministry, we are praying for the Jews. The persecution is horrendous, is beyond, in my own country, the persecution is beyond what you can even imagine or fathom. You see that the news here in Norway, in my country of Norway, they are very disappointed. Very, very disappointed because IDF soldiers have not been alerted down to those Hamas tunnels. This was what they were hoping for after 7th October, because everyone knew that Israel was going to retaliate. And they hoped that the IDF soldiers were going to be forced down into those tunnels to target the Hamas terrorists. But the war has been undertaken in another way, so people are disappointed that the death tolls for IDF soldiers are so low. Can you believe that? They want higher death tolls for the IDF soldiers because they are against the nation of Israel. They are against Jews. Stay strong, Prime Minister Netanyahu. God is with you. God is with Israel. I don't want to say so much about it, but we can just see the recent example of that Iranian chapter that suddenly crashed and killed the president and the foreign minister and those other people on the helicopter. How can that happen just out of the blue? People don't want to admit that the God of Israel is behind it, the God of the Hebrews. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The God that we serve, the God that both Jews and Christian serve. There is one God. There is no common God for Muslims, for Christians, for Jews, but there is a common God for Christians and Jews, and that's the true Lord. Stay strong. We are praying for Israel, we are praying for Netanyahu, we are praying for IDF, and we pray that you will manage to pluck out each and every terrorist. That includes civilian Palestinians that took part in the slaughter of 1,200 Jews on 7th October last year. Yes, even these experts, so-called experts here in my country, they say and they underscore that it was even more, maybe more civilian Palestinians that slaughtered Jews on 7th October. Remember that?